thank you. Second group of the snake, by using teeth, is the venomous snake. And the, in the venomous snakes, we group them in three type of the teeth. Some they got the front fangs, fix it. Some they got the front fangs, movable. Some they got the front fangs, or they got the rear fangs, sorry. Some they got the rear fangs. So for those which got rear fangs, we call them optoglyphus. Optoglyphus, these snakes, they possess fang at the back of their jaw, right here, at the back here. If you can see, you can put your eyes right here, you can see this something pointing out right in the back here. This is what we call the octopus. And they possess hemotoxic. This is the venom which attacking blood cells and clotting mechanism.
Okay, that so, means the poison tends to do some clotting in the blood.
Anticoagulating.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's doing anticoagulating. So the victim from this type of snake, they bleed to death without antivenom. And they, a little bit difficult to get the antivenom, except for the boomslang, which right now in South Africa they produce antivenom for the boomslang bite. But for the most of them, for this snake of the octoglyphus, because they are rear fangs, it's not easy to bite a human and inject the venom. Most of them, they feed on the lizards, like the chameleons. So once they grab the chameleon, they have to push the chameleon right back to the fangs. You get it?
Okay.
So they have to push it right back quickly to the back to inject the venom. The function of the venom in from the snake to their prey is to immobilize the prey. So once the prey gets bitten, you will see the struggling, but as the time goes, you will see the movement goes down and then death, and then they swallow it whole.
Okay, just a question of curiosity.
Yes.
You said that in South Africa currently they are trying to make, or they are producing the
antivenom.
Does it mean that every snake has its own antivenom, or it's just that a certain antivenom can be used for any bite of any poisonous snake?
For this snake, for the boomslang, it has only its own antivenom.
How about other snakes?
They have their polyvalent, which is catacross. But the difference in the dose. Some, we need a large dose. Yes, depends on the type of one. Yeah.
So what's the basic difference between the snakes with venom and the one which do not have venom, apart from the fact that one has poison, the other doesn't?
As I tell you, through the teeth, I say teeth, but here I say fangs. The python and the other non-venom snake, they have the same shape, size, teeth. But these teeth, if you open in their mouth, especially in the python, the upper jaw, you can see the four rows, means two in one side and the another side, you see the rows of the teeth. And in the lower jaw, you can see two rows of the teeth. These are the normal with the same shape and size, which are not grooved to inject the venom. But for a snake like this one, it got a few teeth plus two fangs at the back. You get it? These are many teeth, like you can see. These are many teeth.
And of the same shape and size.
Same shape and size. But this one, you get a few. Must be plus two fangs. Fangs must be grouped to pass the venom. Yeah.
So one of the things to note, everybody, is that there is a basic and a very